Passive filters presented by Mellow Outlook. In this tutorial, we will focus on passive filters. Passive filters are made up of passive components such as resistors, capacitors, and inductors, and have no amplifying elements like transistors or amps. Therefore, there will be no signal gain, and the output level will always be less than the input. Depending upon which way we connect the resistor and the capacitor with regards to the output signal, it will determine the type of the filter construction, resulting in either a low pass filter or a high pass filter. The main function of any filter basically is to allow signal of a given band of frequencies to pass unaltered while attenuating or weakening all others that are not wanted. Therefore, depending upon the amplitude response characteristics of an ideal filter, by using an ideal frequency response curve, there are four basic filter types. The first one being the low pass filter, high pass filter, band pass filter, and then the band stop filter. We will focus mainly on the low pass filter and the high pass filter in this particular tutorial. So what is low pass filter? Low pass filter allows low frequency signals from 0 Hz to its cutoff frequency FL, represented in this ideal case, to pass while blocking the frequencies greater than the cutoff. So you can see in this ideal frequency response curve, this band of frequency is allowed to pass, and greater than FL, it is attenuated or eliminated. In the case of high pass filter, this will allow only high frequency signals from its cutoff frequency. So here the cutoff frequency is FH, and it will allow the frequency from this FH up till infinity to pass through it while blocking those frequencies less than FH. So as you can clearly see, and in general we call the cutoff frequency to be represented as FC. Coming to the first topic, that is RC low pass filter. As I have mentioned earlier, we are going to make use of passive components. So in this low pass filter circuit, we have made use of a resistor and a capacitor, and output is measured across the capacitor. Depending upon the arrangement of the resistor and the capacitor, we can classify it as either low pass or high pass. Here the output voltage is measured across the capacitor, and hence we call it as a low pass filter. RC, because we are making use of the resistor and the capacitor component. So before understanding this circuit, we need to understand the concept of capacitive reactance, and I have already shared the capacitive reactance tutorial earlier. In that tutorial, we have seen that the reactance of a capacitor varies inversely with frequency, and that is also shown in this particular equation, which says XC is equal to 1 by 2 pi FC. So you can see that the frequency is inversely proportional to the capacitive reactance. So now we need to compute what is the output voltage of this particular circuit. So as you can see here, this resistor and capacitor basically are connected in series, and we have named this particular node as node A. So we will be computing the voltage at this particular node by using the voltage divider rule. So applying the voltage divider rule, whatever voltage we obtain at this particular node A is nothing but corresponding to the output voltage. So you have V out to be equal to VA, that is equal to the input voltage multiplied with minus JXC divided by R minus JXC. Now we need to take the magnitude of this. So when you take the magnitude, you have the output voltage to be equal to input voltage, and as you know, the magnitude of this will be equal to 1. So square root of XC square divided by R square plus XC square. So this term R square plus XC square can be represented as Z. So the final equation is equal to V out to be equal to XC divided by Z. Or if I want to represent in terms of gains, it will be equal to V out by V in, output by input voltage. So that will be equal to XC divided by square root of R square plus XC square. Now this gain equation is very essential for me if I want to draw the frequency response of this particular filter. And this filter basically is a first order low pass filter. Now how do we differentiate it as first order, second order and so on? I will explain you later. But first let me explain you how we have obtained this particular frequency response. So when you want to plot the frequency response for any filter, we will have to find out what will be the value of the gain at three different frequencies. One is at low frequency, one is at the cutoff frequency, and one is at high frequencies. So coming to the equation for the gain, I will check what will happen to the value of XC in comparison to R at low frequencies. And in the tutorial of capacitive reactants, we have seen that when the frequency is very low, that is here, when the frequency is very low, as capacitive reactants is inversely proportional, when frequency is very low, your capacitive reactants will be very high. So this value of XC will be very much greater than the resistance R which is connected in series. So substituting that in this particular equation, I can write this equation as XC, this becomes almost negligible, divided by square root of XC square. So XC divided by square root of XC square, the gain will almost be equal to 1. And if I want to compute the value in decibels, that will be computed as gain is equal to 20 log of AV. And since AV is equal to 1, that will be equal to 0 dB. So we have obtained at low frequencies the gain to be equal to 0 dB. This is a decimal value, whereas this value is in terms of decibels. Now, at the cutoff frequency. So at the cutoff frequency, we are assuming that both the capacitive reactance and the resistance to be the same, and when we substitute the value to be the same, so this equation for gain will be XC divided by XC square plus XC square, or I can say that XC divided by square root of 2 times XC square. So that is equal to 1 by square root of 2, or the gain will be equal to 0.707. So if you want to compute the value in decibels, that will be equal to minus 3 dB, and that is pointed out here. So when you draw minus 3 dB from its original value, you will be able to compute what will be the cutoff frequency. So we have seen two cases at low frequency and at cutoff frequency. Now we want to observe what happens at higher frequencies. So again, if you refer to this particular equation, at higher frequencies, the capacitive reactance will be very less. So when the capacitive reactance is very less compared to the resistance that is connected in series, your gain will start dropping at a rate of minus 20 dB per decade. Basically, your gain is decreasing after your cutoff frequency. The rate at which it decreases will categorize whether it is first order, second order, third order, fourth order, fifth order, or any order filter. In this particular case, it drops at a rate of 20 dB per decade. That is why we call it as a first order low pass filter. So it is all dependent on the equation of the gain and on these three categories that you obtain your frequency response curve. So same thing has been illustrated here. So your pass band is the band between 0 to the cutoff frequency, and after the cutoff frequency, your frequency is basically, your output signal is basically getting attenuated at higher frequencies. And this slope is minus 20 dB per decade, which decides that it is a first order filter. And from the cutoff, you have the stop band. Moving on to the higher order filter. So this RC low pass filter we have seen is for the first order. When we represent in terms of decade, it means that each time frequency increases by a factor of 10, your gain falls at a rate of 20 dB. Whereas when we represent in terms of octave, it means that each time your frequency is doubled, the gain falls at a rate of 6 dB. So we can represent either in terms of the roll-off factor in terms of decade or in terms of octave. For a first order, we call it as minus 20 dB per decade or minus 6 dB per octave. Now coming to the second order low pass filter. In the second order low pass filter, we are going to make use of two passive first order low pass filters which will be connected in cascade to form the second order. As you can see, this is the first RC stage and this is the second RC stage. The first order low pass filter can be converted into second order type by simply adding an additional RC network to it. And the more the RC stages we add, the higher becomes the order of the filter. So if we were to add a third RC stage, we would have obtained a third order filter. So if the number of RC stages that are cascaded together is represented as N, the resulting RC filter circuit will be known as the nth order filter, with the roll off represented as N into minus 20 dB per decade. For example, for a second order filter, N will be equal to 2 and the roll off slope will be equal to 2 into minus 20 dB per decade. So that will be equal to minus 40 dB per decade. So when we are going to use identical RC filter stages which are connected together, the output gain at the required cutoff frequency will be reduced by an amount in relation to the number of filter stages used as the roll-off slope increases. So as you can see, the passive low-pass filter gain at a frequency fc will then be equal to 1 by square root of 2 to the power n. So previously, when we were having the first order low pass filter, we had the gain to be equal to 1 by square root of 2 at the cutoff frequency. Whereas now, when we are having second order filter, this n will be equal to 2. So that is why we represent it as 1 by square root of 2 to the power 2, or in general, it is n corresponding to the number of filter stages. Then coming to the equation for the corner frequency. The corner frequency for the second order passive filter will be determined by the RC combinations that we are using. Since we are using two RC combinations, so we have FC to be equal to 1 by 2 pi R1C1 R2C2 measured in hertz. Now coming to the frequency response. So this frequency response is basically a combination of both the first order and the second order. And the first order is represented by the blue color. You can see that the gain, the cutoff frequency was 1 by square root of 2. So that is why it was represented as minus 3 dB. And the slope was minus 20 dB per decade. Now what happens is, when you have the second order filter, you will have a steeper roll off. So that is why the slope will be equal to minus 40 dB per decade. So this will be your second order cutoff frequency. So this is the pass band, and from here you will have the stop band. So this frequency response curve clearly states that as the number of stages increases, your roll off will become more and more steeper. If I am representing in terms of decade as minus 40 dB per decade, in terms of octave it will be minus 12 dB per octave. And we have the equation for gain, which is in terms of decibels, and it is a function of the output value, which is divided by its corresponding input value. So this will be computed as 20 log of Vout by. So before we move on to the high pass filter, to summarize, the low pass filter has a constant output voltage from 0 to the cutoff frequency fc, and this cutoff frequency point is at 0.707 or minus 3 dB, and up till this value of your voltage gain, the signal is allowed to pass, and the frequency range below this cutoff point fc is called as the pass band, because it allows the signal to pass, and the frequency range above this cutoff point is called as the stop band, as the signal will be blocked from passing. So next, so in the high pass filter circuit, the arrangement is almost the same, just that we are going to interchange the capacitor and the resistor. So whatever equations we had computed in the previous case, only the difference is when you apply the voltage divider rule, you are going to have the equation for output voltage to be equal to R into input voltage divided by R minus JXC. When you take the magnitude of the equation, you obtain as R divided by square root of R square plus XC square. And in terms of equation for gain, V out by V in, this is what you get. Again, here we want to compute or draw the frequency response, means we have to find out what will be the value of the gain at three different cases: at low frequency, at high frequency, and at cutoff frequency. So if you observe, at low frequency, your XC value is very high because it is inversely proportional. As I have explained in the capacitive reactance tutorial, the relationship is inversely proportional. So because XC is very high, this term, your output voltage is almost equal to zero. So you can see that in the graph, and this increase is represented as plus dB per 20 dB per decade. And at the cutoff frequency, you will have the value of gain to be equal to 0.707 in decimal, or whereas in dB it will be equal to minus 3 dB. For higher frequency, your value of XC is very, very low. So the value of gain will be equal to 1, and that is equal to 0 decibel. The difference between the frequency response of the low pass filter and the high pass filter for the first order, if you observe, the roll off was minus there, because after the cutoff frequency your gain was falling, whereas in this particular case your gain is increasing from the beginning. So that is why we represent it as plus 20 dB per decade. So likewise, we can represent this as plus 6 dB per octave for the roll off. So below the cutoff frequency it is called as the stop band, and greater than the cutoff frequency we call it as pass band. Now coming to the second order high pass filter, the way I have explained for the low pass filter second order, same thing applies to this as well. We will be cascading the two stages. So as the number of stages increases, what happens is your value of gain will be equal to 1 by square root of 2 to the power n. And the equation for the cutoff frequency, which is also called as a corner frequency, everything remains the same like the low pass filter. we are not going to have any change in the equations, except that the frequency response will be in terms of plus 40 dB per decade. The difference lies mainly in the roll off. So that is what is being shown in this particular graph. Here you can see that it is plus 40 dB per decade because you have a steeper, much steeper roll off, and this is plus 20 dB per decade. This graph basically shows you in blue color for the first order, in red color for the second order. So mainly what you have to remember here is, as you go for higher order, your frequency response curve will become much, much steeper, and your corner frequency equation will be directly dependent on the number of stages that you are going to cascade. These concepts that we have understood regarding passive filters will be applicable while studying the active filters. So under active filters, in the next tutorial, we'll be explaining you the low pass, high pass, band pass, and band stop filters. Thank you for watching.